दुर्भित्र क्यात्मकर्मणि निर्गुणाय गुणेशाय सत्स्थाय सांप्रतम। ट्रांसलेशन बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद। माय लॉर्ड, ऑल ऑब्लिगेशंस टू यू हु आर इटर्नल बियॉन्ड टाइम्स लिमिट्स ऑफ पास्ट प्रेजेंट एंड फ्यूचर। यू आर इनकॉन्सीवेबल इन योर एक्टिविटीज। यू आर द मास्टर ऑफ द थ्री मोड्स ऑफ मेटल नेचर एंड बींग ट्रांसेंडेंटल टू ऑल मेटेरियल क्वालिटीज। यू आर फ्री फ्रॉम मेटेरियल कंटामिनेशन। यू आर द कंट्रोलर ऑफ ऑल थ्री ऑफ द मोड्स ऑफ नेचर। बट एट द प्रेजेंट यू आर इन फेवर ऑफ द क्वालिटी ऑफ गुडनेस। लेट अस ऑफर आवर रेस्पेक्टफुल ओबेसेंसेस अनटू यू। पर्पट बाय श्रील प्रभुपाद। द सुप्रीम पर्सनालिटी गॉडहेड कंट्रोल्स द मेटेरियल एक्टिविटीज manifested by the three modes of material nature. As stated in Bhagavad Gita, nirgunam guna bhoktrucha, the Supreme Personality Godhead is always transcendental to the material qualities, sattva-guna, raja-guna, and tama-guna. But nonetheless, he is their controller. The Lord manifests himself in three features, as Brahma, Vishnu, and Maheshwara, to control these three qualities. He personally takes charge of Sattva Guna as Lord Vishnu, and he entrusts the charge of Raja Guna and Tama Guna to Lord Brahma and Lord Shiva. Ultimately, however, he is the controller of the three gunas. Lord Brahma, expressing his appreciation, said that because Lord Vishnu had now taken charge of the activities of goodness, there was every hope that demigods would be successful in fulfilling their desires. The demigods were harassed by the demons who were infested with tamaguna. However, as Lord Brahma has previously described, since the time of sattva guna had now arrived, demigods could naturally expect to fulfill their desires. Demigods are supposedly well advanced in knowledge. 8. They couldn't understand the knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Therefore, the Lord is addressed here as Anantaya. Although Lord Brahma knows past, present, and future, he is unable to understand the unlimited knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thus, when the Bhaktivedanta purports the 8th canto, 5th chapter of the Srimad Bhagavatam entitled, here Brahmaji says that the Supreme Personality Godhead controls the material activities manifested by three modes of material nature. He is the controller of material nature, three modes of material nature. One thing he says here, that Lord is addressed here as Anantaya. Although Lord Brahma knows past, present, and future, he is unable to understand the unlimited knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Brahma is one of the Mahajanas. He knows Bhagavad Gita. Still, it is said that Bhagavan is addressed here as Anantaya. He is unlimited. Ananta means unlimited. Although Brahma knows past, present, future, is unable to understand the unlimited knowledge of Supreme Personality of Godhead. Still he is unable. But to speak of some ordinary living entity, and Brahma is unable to understand. And Brahma knows something. Here Brahma says, Bhagavad Tattva, still he is unable to understand completely. And that proof is there. 5,000 years ago, when that Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, in his own swarup, his own original form, had appeared here and then manifested his leela, Brahma couldn't understand. When he was playing with the cowherd boys in the jungle of Vrindavan and tending the cows, calves of Nanda Maharaj, like an ordinary cowherd boy. Brahma couldn't understand. You understand? Brahma couldn't understand. Is he supreme personality to Godhead, supreme controller? He's standing the cows. The calves here. And moving like an ordinary cowherd boy. They were playing. You understand? With the cowherd boys, Krishna and Balaram. Krishna was playing with their cowherd boys. Sometimes in the play there are two groups. One wins and another is defeated. And they have that condition that one will be defeated, he'll carry the winner on his shoulder and run around. So sometimes Krishna becomes defeated. Sridham Gop wins. The Krishna carries Sridham Gop on his shoulder and runs around. Who is the source of all creation? Isn't it? Ananta Brahmanda. Unlimited, the source of unlimited Brahmandas. Isn't it? Supreme personality to Godhead Krishna. And he is carrying the Sridham Gop on his shoulder. Brahma couldn't understand. This is how. Brahma couldn't understand. Is he? Who carries the unlimited Brahmandas, you see? Universes, the source of unlimited universe, all manifestable. He's carrying that cowherd boy on his shoulder. Is he? No, I couldn't understand. You see how that is said here. All Brahma knows past, present, future is unable to understand limited knowledge. The supreme personality of Godhead. You understand? So how can an ordinary living entity understand it? Possible. Nobody can understand. Nam prakasa sarvasya yogamaya samabhruta mudhayam nabhijanati. Bhagavad Gita Krishna says, I do not manifest myself everywhere and not before everybody else. I am covered up with my yogamaya. Mudhayam navijanati, rascal. Cannot understand. You understand? One who is mudha, one is rascal, he thinks Krishna, Supreme Personal God, as an ordinary human being. Abhajananti mang mudha, manu singtanu asana, param bhavajananto, mama bhuta maheshwa. Krishna says, mudha. Rascals, they derided me as an ordinary human being. You understand? The rascals. How can they understand? When Brahma fails to understand, then Brahma tried to test him. All right, I'll test how his supreme personality. You understand? He tried to test. So he stole the calves and cowherd boys by dint of his yoga sock. Krishna is Yogeshwar, master of all Yogeshwar. Is Yogeshwar. With mercy of Yogeshwar, Brahma has got some Yogeshwar by his mercy. So that Brahma showed his Yogeshwar before Yogeshwar. Isn't it? Because he couldn't understand. Otherwise, he would not have shown this thing. Krishna was a mere boy, 6-7 year old boy at that time. So manifesting his childhood pastimes, boyhood pastimes. So he laughed in his mind, oh, Brahma is testing. So immediately he expanded himself in the form of calves and cowherd. The Brahma couldn't understand. Brahma stole them. He put them in one of the caves of the mountain. That's lie. slip. When Brahma, after one moment, came back to see a light. So there would not have been any play now, because I stole, covered boys and cars. But he saw the same play was going on. Same coward boys were there. Same calves were there. What is that? I stole. Who are they? Did Krishna take them back from that cave? He went there to see whether they were lying there. Oh, they were lying here, they were playing. It was so fun. Couldn't understand. As Brahma fails to understand. How can? Ordinary human being can understand. Then he meditated, prayed, then saw all 400 vegetables, the covered boys and cars. Then he couldn't understand, oh, I committed offense. Came down. And offered prayers, begged excuse, please excuse me. Take away this position of Brahma from me now. I don't want it. Because of this position, I developed such pride. So I committed such offenses at the lotus feet. So take it away from me immediately. I don't want it. Tadastu menatas guribhago pavitruanyatru tubastrasyaṁ ekumbhavāpi bhavajjanānaṁ bhuttāni sevetavapāda pallavam. The 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam find. Yesterday we are quoting many prayers from 10th canto of Brahma Bhagavata. This is one of them. Tadastu menatas guribhago pavitruanyatru tubastrasyaṁ ekumbhavāpi bhavajjanānaṁ bhuttāni sevetavapāda pallavam. Lord, please grant me this thing. This only prayer, I have this only prayer to you. Please give me a birth here in this jungle, Vrindavan. You understand? As a blade of grass. Or any previous places as you like. Whatever Brahmando you may like. Give me any spaces, inferior places. I don't want this position, Brahma. But I have only one thing. Ekam mabapi bhavadjananam bhuttani sevetavapadapallavam. Life after life, I only serve your lotus feet. I'll let me be as one of these calves or coward boys. So fortunate they are. These calves and coward boys are so fortunate. They are playing with you. You are playing with them. I am so unfortunate. I am not so fortunate. Let me burn in any inferior spaces, in any Brahmand. But I have this prayer. Let me be one of them. So that my life will be successful. He prayed like that. He couldn't understand. That is stated. Only who understands Krishna? Who understands Krishna? One who has gotten the mercy of Krishna, he understands. Nobody can understand Krishna by dint of his own merit, and knowledge, and intelligence, whatever. No. Nobody can understand. As we say, nobody can see sun without the help of sunshine. Without the help of sunshine, nobody can see sun. Nobody. At night, there is no sun here. Isn't it? Can any scientist, very powerful scientist, show sun at that time? May he invent or manufacture, create very wonderful machine. Can he show sun at that time? No, no. Cannot. Without the sunshine, we cannot see the sun. Sunshine is required. With the help of sunshine, we see sun. And sun will arise, there is sunshine, then you can see sun. Huh? Otherwise, we cannot see sun. Similarly, without the mercy of the Lord, nobody can understand Lord, see Lord, and understand Lord. Only by the mercy of the Lord. No other way is there. Nanya pantha vidyati uyanayo, it is said in Sweta Svetra Upanishad. Tameva vidityati mruktumeti nanya pantha vidyati uyanayo. Sweta Svetra Upanishad says. That means one can understand that Supreme Personality Godhead in Tattva. Do you understand? Tattva. If someone can understand him Tattva, then he can be completely free from the clutches of Maya and go back home, back to Godhead. Tadamang Tattva to Gyantva Abhisati Tadanantaram Bhagavad Gita Krishna says. When someone knows me in Tattva, then he can enter into me. My kingdom. Janma karma cha me divyam evam jobeti tattvatah tyaktva deham punar janma na eti samayeti arjuna. Fourth chapter, Bhagavad Gita Krishna. My birth, my activities, all spiritual, not material. And one should understand it in tattva. One is fortunate, understands it in tattva. By quitting this body, he will go to me. Enter into my dham, kingdom. There is no doubt in it. Do you understand? So that is said here. Sweta Svetra Upanishad. Tameva vidityati mrutumeti nanya pantha vidyate yanayo. That means one who knows Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead in tattva, that human being is very fortunate. He enters into the Lord's kingdom and become immortal. Because there is no death, no birth, no death, no old age, no disease. Amrutattva. Amrutattva kalabhaya. Do you understand? In other words, we may say, in that board of Krishna, one always tastes that amruta, nectar. You understand? That means in the abode of Krishna, all are immersed in the ocean of Premananda. You understand? Ocean of Premananda. You understand? Ocean of Prem, bliss. You understand? That ocean. And nanya pantha vidyatayana. There is no other way. This is the only way. This is the only way. No. By his mercy. You understand? So how can one get the mercy of the Lord? That next question. You understand? Only by the mercy of the Lord one can understand. How can one get his mercy? That's another question. How can one get it? By sadhu. You understand? Bhakta, sadhu. Pure devotee. Those who are pure devotees, sadhus, they distribute mercy. If someone associates by sadhus, Vaishnavas, pure devotees, by their association, one may get their mercy. Thereby, you'll get mercy of the Lord. Jasya prasada, the Bhagavad prasada. By the mercy of that sadhu guru, one can get the mercy of Krishna. Otherwise, one cannot get. Then one can understand. You understand? In 10th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, also you'll find तेषां सत्त्वयुक्तानां भवतां प्रतिपूर्वकं ददामि बुद्धियोगं तं येन मम उपजान्ति ते तेषाम् एव अनुकम्पार्थम् अहम् अज्ञानजं तम नाशयामि आत्मभावस्थो ज्ञानदीपेन भास्वत। Isn't it? Tenth chapter. Tesam sattasuktanam bhajatam pritipurvakam. He says, one who is constantly attached to me and doing my bhajan with love, priti. So I give him buddhi yoga. That is bhakti yoga. Through which he can come to me. Tesam eva anukampartam anga jnana jantama. Nāśayāmi ātma-bhāvastha jñāna-dīpe-hira-vāsa. Next verse says, out of mercy, compassion, anukampa. Anukampa means compassion or mercy. Out of compassion and mercy, I dispel the darkness of ignorance. The lamp of knowledge, vāsvata, very effulgent lamp of knowledge. You understand? I dispel the darkness of ignorance from his heart and enkindle the very effulgent lamp of knowledge in his heart. That means this knowledge comes from him. Through that knowledge one can understand him. And that is through his mercy. You understand? One who does sadhana bhajan. You understand? You understand? Constantly attached and constantly doing bhajan with love. Pridipurvakam. You understand? Bhajatam pridipurvakam. You understand? How can one do that? Nobody can do bhajan by himself. You understand? Adu sraddha tada sadhu sango atho bhajan kriya. Rupa Goswami says. Adu sraddha tada sadhu sango atho bhajan kriya. Then bhajan kriya. One must associate with sadhus. They are devotees of the Lord, Vaishnavas. Those are always engaged in loving bhajan, pridipurna bhajan. One should approach them. Tadvijyartham sa guru bhavi gatcha samitpani sutriyam brahmanishtam. Upanishad says, one who is very eager, extremely eager to understand Krishna. How can I understand? You understand? He must approach such a person. Sa gurunga bhavi gacchat. Sutriyam brahmanishtam. Samitpani sutriyam brahmanishtam. Who is that guru? Sutriyam brahmanishtam. Who comes in srauta paramparjo in hearing process. Hearing process. Srauta paramparjo. Sutriya. Not speculator. The hearing process, descending process. Acharyavana purusavedaha, Upanishad says. Who knows? Acharyavana purusa. One who has served acharya and heard from that bona fide acharya, serving him, satisfying him, pleasing him. You understand? Has gotten his mercy, he has obtained this tattva-jnana, acharya, by hearing process, srauta paramparjo, his brahmanishtha, his guru. One must approach such a guru who comes under this bona fide disciplic succession, hearing process. Tattva-jnanartham sa guru bhavikacha smitvani satyam brahmanishtham. Tadvidhi pranipatena pariprasnana sevaya padakhyanti te jnanam jnanina tattva darshan. This is the process. Sishadeham sadhimam tamrabannam. First duty of sishya, disciple. I become your sishya. I accept you as my guru. Become your disciple. I come under your complete discipline. Disciple is under discipline. Please inflict discipline. Severe discipline on me. I am indisciplined. Sadhiman. Then impart the tattva-jnana. You understand? Pray. Pray. At the lotus feet of शिष्यतेहं साधिमंतम, आई कंप्लीटली सरेंडर माई सेल्फ अन योर लोटस फीट गुरु आचार्य. यू अंडरस्टैंड? प्रणिपातो परिप्रश्न सेवा. थ्री, फर्स्ट सरेंडर, देन रेंडर सर्विस, सैटिस्फाई गुरु आचार्य, प्लीज हिम, देन हम्बली आस्क क्वेश्चन, क्वेश्चन रिलेटिंग टू दिस तत्व, भगवत तत्व. देन आउट ऑफ मर्सी ही विल इम्पार्ट दिस नॉलेज. This way, this tattva jnan is received. This mercy is received. You understand? Through a sadhu. Through a sadhu. Sadhu is distributing that mercy. Sadhu has come down here in this material world with that ocean of mercy. Krishna is the ocean of mercy. But sadhu has come down here with the ocean of mercy. You understand? Distributing. One should approach. So sadhu, you understand? Then he can get that mercy. He'll become the disciple, and the sadhu will, guru will teach you how to do bhajan with love. So bhajan kriya, you understand? Sadhu sungu, bhajan kriya. Otherwise, one cannot do bhajan by himself. He doesn't know how to do bhajan. He doesn't know. So teacher is required, guru is required. He will teach you how to do bhajan. You understand? Then you can get the mercy. Then the all ignorance in your heart will be dispelled. And must be effulgent, the lamp of knowledge will be enkindled. Then you can, that is the mercy. Then you can know him. Tattva and understand him. Otherwise one cannot know him. And he said, it is said in Kathopanishad, Jadidam kincha jagat sarvam prano edatini srutam mahadabhavam vajramadhadam jayetad vidunmutante bhavanti. Kathopanishad. You understand? Kathopanishad says this. Nonsense. You understand? The whole universe, the whole universe is based on whom? Based on that Supreme Lord, isn't it? Without him, is there any existence? No. So, the whole universe, everything is based on him. Do you understand? He is the base. But there are some pandits, some pandits, like Mayabadis, they are great pandits, scholars. They think themselves to be great scholars and pandits. They say that the Sabitu, Sabitu means Surya. The sun is the base. They say so. You understand? They don't say the Supreme Lord. They say so. But Vedanta Sutra says what? You should understand what Vedanta Sutra says. Vedanta Sutra says everything is based upon that Supreme Lord. Sabitu. Do you understand? That Supreme Lord has carried Sankho Chukru Guda Puddha, console disc, lotus and club. Do you understand? Etat ja vidur mutaste bhavanti. Kathopanishad says, if someone can understand that Lord Hari, that Supreme Lord, then he can completely, do you understand? Completely go beyond this three modes of material nature and approach Supreme Lord and enter into the kingdom of the Lord. He can cross over this dreadful ocean of material existence. That is says. He'll go beyond death. become immortal, go beyond death. You understand? In that abode, there is no question of sun, moon, agni, fire, electricity, and air. No influence of time also, kala. You understand? That Upanishad says, one who has defective vision, he puts on a speck, eyeglass, speck, isn't it? Then he can see things. So, you remove speck from your eyes. Can the speck see? No. Specks cannot see. That is, with the eye, then you can see. Similarly, the Surya, the sun, Agni, that means fire, Vayu, wind, unless they are controlled by that Supreme Lord Hari, they have no existence at all. No existence at all. They cannot do anything. Under their his control, they do. They give effulgence. The sun and moon give effulgence. Fire gives effulgence. You understand? So, Mundaka Upanishad, Katha Upanishad, Sudhasvedra Upanishad, all say, Na tatra surya bhavati, na chandra tarakam name, nema vidyuto bhanti kutoyam agni, tameva bhano manubhati sarvam tasya bhasa sarvam idam vibhati. You understand? All Upanishads say. Mundak, Katha, Sudhasvedra, all Upanishads say. You understand? What does Surya do? What does Surya do? Yes. Surya gives light. That light, the effulgence of Surya, comes from the effulgence, bodily effulgence of Krishna. Tateja vidhimamakam. You understand? In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, what is that verse? Don't you know Bhagavad Gita? Tateja vidhimamakam. You understand? The effulgence of sun and moon, agni, fire, comes from me. You understand? That verse is there. Sasis prabhasmi sasisurjaya. That's another verse also. Prabhasmi sasisurjaya. I am the effulgence in moon and sun. Krishna says. Tateja vidhimamakam. The effulgence you will find in Surya, in sun, in moon, in agni, in fire. You should understand that effulgence comes from me. So without help of Supreme Lord Hari, that Savitu or Surya, or Sandra cannot do anything. And the Surya or Sandra, the sun and moon only give light here in this material world. Thereby, with that light, you can see some material objects here. Isn't it? And in the dense dark night, cloudy night, there is some lightning. With that lightning, for a moment you can see something, for a moment. But the person whose heart has been enkindled by the most effulgent light of knowledge, you understand? Gyandip. Can understand Krishna. Do you understand? Can understand Krishna eternally. He sees Krishna everywhere. He knows Krishna very well. Whose heart has been made effulgent by Jnana Deep, by the effulgent lamp and kindled by Krishna in his heart. That is said. And before that person, all these planets of Surya, Sun, the Moon, the fire, the electricity, are most insignificant. Insignificant. Because all of them are controlled by that Supreme Lord, Hari. Without Him, they have no existence at all. Mayabuddha Jiva, the conditioned soul, who has forgotten Krishna, is captured by Maya. He thinks that this Surya, Sun, fire, Vayu, wind, air, help us in our survival. Without their help, Jiva cannot survive. But what the Upanishads say, what the Mahajanas say, without the help of the Supreme Lord Krishna, the Surya, the Sun, the Moon, the fire, the Vayu, the air, cannot exist. Do you understand? Cannot exist. That means, in other words, we may say, without the Supreme Lord Krishna or Hari, no living entity cannot exist. That is the conclusion. And all of them, the Surya, the Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwar, Surya, Sun, Moon, Air, Higher God, all are obedient servants or carriers of that Supreme Lord Krishna. You understand? As we say, the specs, eyeglass, cannot see things separately, independently. Similarly, this Vayu, Agni, Surya, all of them cannot do anything independently unless they are controlled by the Supreme Controller Hari. So that Krishna, the Supreme Krishna, is the base of everything. You understand? And one who gets that, the mercy of that Supreme Lord Krishna, he can understand. You understand? How can one get that mercy? One can get that mercy through his dear devotees. Sadhus Mahajanas. Therefore, by abusing one's minute independence, the jiva becomes captured by Maya, forgets Krishna. You understand? Mamivansa jiva loke jiva bhutta sanatana. Jiva, living entity, is eternally my fragmental part and parcel. 15th chapter Bhagavad Gita says so. So, what are there in Krishna? All are there in jiva, all qualities, everything. You understand? So, Krishna is the supreme enjoyer, isn't it? Supreme enjoyer. Angi sarvajagyanam bhokta cha. Isn't it? Sarvajagyanam bhokta. I am the bhokta, I am the enjoyer, Krishna says. He is the enjoyer. Jiva is not enjoyer. Krishna is the only enjoyer. Jiva is not enjoyer. You must be enjoyed. But jiva being, minute part and parcel of that Krishna who is enjoyer, this attitude of enjoyment is there in jiva in a minute proportion. Therefore, he wants to enjoy. You understand? Therefore, jiva wants to enjoy. Because that attitude of enjoyment is there in minute proportion. Because he is the eternal part and parcel of the supreme enjoyment. So when he abuses that, thinks himself forgetting Krishna, thinks himself as enjoyer, he abuses his mental independence and he is captured by Maya at that time. And he comes down here to this material world. Jesava jiver bhagavansha upajilo. In Kalyan Kalpataru, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Mahajan says this thing. Jesava jiver bhagavansha upajilo purusha bhavete tara jade pravesilo. You understand? Those who develop this attitude of enjoyment, they come here to this material world as purusha to enjoy. Jiva jadi hoilen Krishna bahirmukho maya devi tave tare jajilen sukha. Then he is captured by Maya. He forgot Krishna. Yeah? Then Maya Devi gives him some enjoyment. Maya sukhe matta jiva Sri Krishna bhulilo. Sei se avidya vase asmita janilo. You understand? Maya means avidya, ignorance. Maya hoy undhokar. Maya is ignorance. Maya is darkness. Yeah? When jiva is captured by Maya, forgets Krishna, then saying, he thinks himself, I am proprietor, I am Lord, I am enjoyer. This I, asmita. This is avidya. Out of avidya, these things develop in me. Asmita hoite hoila Maya ni Maya bhiniveso. Jodogo tor agar dves. Due to this asmita, I-ness. Ahankar vimudatma karta hungiti manyate. Gita says. Ahankar vimudatma. Who is builded by false ego. I is very great. It's captured by Maya. So, in this material world, he develops rag and dvesa. He likes some object or some persons and dislikes some object and some persons. Rag and dvesa. Eirupe jiva karma chakri pravesya uchabo chogati krame phirena bhramya. In this way, he revolves in the wheel of karma chakra. Sometimes goes high, sometimes goes down. কোথা সে বৈকুণ্ঠানন্দ শ্রীকৃষ্ণ বিলাস কোথা মায়াগত সুখ দুঃখ সর্বনাশ না ওয়ের ইজ দ্যাট বৈকুণ্ঠানন্দ আনন্দ ইন বৈকুণ্ঠ অ্যান্ড ওয়ের ইজ দ্যাট সাফারিং ইন দিস মেটেরিয়াল ওয়ার্ল্ড মায়াগত সুখ দ্য হ্যাপিনেস দ্যাট মায়া গিভস ফ্লিটিং টেম্পোরারি হ্যাপিনেস হুজ আউটকাম ইজ আনলিমিটেড মিজারি ভ্রমিতে ভ্রমিতে যদি সাধু সঙ্গ হয় পুনরায় গুপ্ত নিত্য ধর্মরে উদয় সাধু সঙ্গে কৃষ্ণ কথা হয় আলোচন পূর্বভাব উদিকাটে মায়ার বন্ধন ইন দিস ওয়ে রিভলভিং আন্ডারগোয়িং লাক্স অফ স্পেস ইজ অফ লাইফ হাই অ্যান্ড লো ইফ বাই সাম অজ্ঞাত সুকৃতি ইউ আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড অ্যাসোসিয়েটস উইথ সাধু ভ্রমিতে ভ্রমিতে সাধু সঙ্গ হয় by the association of sadhu, he, by his mercy, permissively hearing from sadhu, gets his mercy, then he can understand who is he, what is the real identity. Sadhu sange, Krishna katha, hoya lochon, purpa bhava udikate mayar bandhan. He is sadhu, one who speaks only about Krishna. When he opens his mouth, he speaks about nothing else. He never speaks any Gramya Katha, politics. Only Krishna. Only Krishna Katha is discussed there in the association of sadhus. In a fortunate soul, fortunate living entity, associates with sadhus, and hears some miserable Krishna Katha, then gets the mercy of Krishna that comes through sadhu. By hearing Krishna Katha from the lips of sadhu, gets mercy. Then he can understand, who am I? Oh, Ami Krishna Das. I am servant of Krishna. I am servant of Krishna. Now he understands. Then he says, alas, what I have done? Lakhs of lives I have forgotten Krishna. I have served Maya. Keno Maya Daso? Why have I become Maya Das? Servant of Maya. Kende bole, hey Krishna, Ami Tava Das. Tomar Chana Chadi Hvinusam. Then he will cry. Oh Krishna, I am your servant. But now I am completely doomed. Forgetting your lotus feet. Vailu Sarvanas. Do you understand? Nijo Tattva Dhani Ar Sansara Na Chai. Kenava Vajilu Maya Kore Hai Hai. When you understand by the association of sadhu, hearing from a sadhu, that is Krishna Das. He is the servant of Krishna. Then he understands they have been completely doomed, forgetting Krishna. Becoming Maya Das, or Sansar Nasai, then he doesn't want anymore to be entangled with this Sansar, with the material world. Or Sansar Nasai, Kenava Bhojilu Maya Korya. Then he says, alas, alas, what I have done, why I have served Maya, alas, alas. What I have done. He accuses himself. You understand? Kende bole, hey Krishna, Ami Tava Das. Tumar Chana Chari Huyu Sarvana. Then he cries, kende. Oh Krishna, I am your servant, but I have been completely doomed now, forgetting your lotus feet. You understand? When this condition, this situation is there, when jiva will cry like this, by the association of sadhus, understanding his real identity with he, and then he gets mercy. You understand? Then he gets mercy. Krishna is there in the heart as Paramatma's person. He is now awake. Oh, now he's crying for me. So I must help him. Krishna lena chitsakiravala maya hoy drubol. You understand? Krishna dena chisakti ravala maya vaidrubbol. Then he gets strength from Krishna, his spiritual strength that comes from Krishna through sadhu. Then maya becomes powerless. Otherwise, maya will never be powerless. Nobody can overcome maya by dint of his own strength. Mayam eva ce prabudyante Maya metang taruntiti, Gita says. And completely surrenders to me with the master of Maya is Krishna. Maya adhisa. Krishna is Maya adhisa. Krishna is the master of Maya. Here he says, he's a controller. You understand? He's their controller. Sattvagun, rajagun, tamagun. Nonetheless, he's their controller. Isn't it? He's Maya adhisa. He's the master of Maya. You understand? When his master says, when Maya's master says, set him free, set this soul free, because Maya has imprisoned you in a prison house, then her master will say, set him free, then Maya will set you free. Otherwise, you cannot overcome Maya by dint of your own strength. Krishna dena chisakti ravala maya hoidu. When some fortunate soul, fortunate jiva, gets spiritual strength in this way, gets spiritual strength from Krishna, then maya becomes powerless. Then he can overcome maya. Sadhu sangye Krishna kathaya alocha. Prabhava udhikate maya rabandhan. Then he will free from the clutches of maya. This is how can one get the mercy of Krishna. Then he can understand Krishna. Then he can approach Krishna. Yes, Krishna. Otherwise, not possible. You understand? Not possible. Sri Krishna Vimukha Jano Aishwarya Rase Mai Ko Jodiye Sukhe Buddha Maya Paase Akinchana Atmarato Krishna Ratisar Jani Bhukti Mukti Asa Kori Parihar Sansare Jivan Jatra Unaya Se Kari Nitya Dehe Nitya Seve Atma Pradahari. You understand? Bhakti Vinod Thakur says Kalyana Karpa. Sri Krishna Vimukha Jano Aishwarya Rase Sri Krishna Vimukha was forgetting Krishna. Person who has forgotten Krishna is always running after this material enjoyment, material opulence, Aishwarya. Do you understand? Mai ko jodiyo sukhe buddha maya pas. Therefore, he has been entrapped by maya. Because he wants to enjoy maya. And entrapped by maya. But in this way, when he gets the association of sadhus, gets the mercy, of Krishna through the sadhus and understands his own identity, then he doesn't want any more maya. You understand? And he cries and gets the spiritual strength from Krishna and completely is now free from this maya and becomes a kinchan dina. No false ego is there. I am so great. No. Now he becomes dina, a kinchan. You understand? He dina, akinchan. Akinchan atma rato krishna rati sar. Jani bhukti mukti asa kare pariha. He gives up the desire of bhukti and mukti. Enjoyment and liberation. Completely. Bhavatad bhakti rahit. Janma nijan. Life after life. I serve lotus feet of Krishna. Humble attitude. Sansari jivan jatra unaya shekari. Nitya dehe nitya seve atma pradahari. That person is now free from all fear. Do you understand? Was completely surrendered unto the lotus feet of Krishna. He never is not afraid of this material existence now. Wherever he may be, he is completely free. There is no influence of this maya on him. He is completely free. Anaya se. Do you understand? He earns his livelihood very easily here. The karmis are toiling hard, like us. But there is no need of toiling. So hard. That they were discussed. You understand? Such a devotee, very easily earns his livelihood here. And doing his bhajan, hari bhajan, nitya deha. His body is no longer metal body. His nitya deha, his spiritual body, eternal body. So with that eternal body, the spiritual body, he is always engaged in loving service of Lord Hari, wherever he may be. He is not afraid, you understand, of this material existence. Whereas all are afraid. You know, he understands Krishna. He sees Krishna. He knows Krishna. He is always with Krishna. He has gotten the mercy of Krishna. In this way, one can understand. Otherwise, not possible. The beginning, one is very much enthused, developed enthusiasm. But after some time, he loses his enthusiasm. No, I have no enthusiasm now. I have lost it. Why do you lose? Why do you lose?
Friends?
Yes. Rupa Goswami says, don't lose. Swaham, nishchaya, dharja, nishchaya, determination, strong determination. I must get. I must get strong determination. I must know. I must approach Krishna. I must know him. I must get him. Determination, strong determination. In this very life, yes. Dhruva Maharaj got. My Guru Maharaj says, what Dhruva got, everybody can get. If he's determined like Dhruva, Dhruva is so determined. It's Dhruva, it's determined. Strong determination. So he says, nishchaya, strong determination. Don't move it. Then dharja, patience. You understand? This is the proof. One is very serious. It is not superfluous. It is very serious to get to understand. We must have patience. He must not lose. He must not be deviated from his determination. He must not lose his enthusiasm. And he will associate with such sadhus. Sadhus. Do you understand? So he will not lose his enthusiasm. If you associate with abhaktas, non-devotees, sangatyagasatamati, therefore said, give up the association of non-devotees. Otherwise, you'll lose it. You'll lose your enthusiasm, you'll lose debate from determination, you'll lose patience, everything. You'll lose. That's what it says. Sangatyaga sutaprati. Give up the association of non-devotees. Always remain in association of satsang. Thereby, you'll develop this thing. Develop bhakti. Develop. Enthusiasm. Your enthusiasm will never be lost. Lose your enthusiasm, will never be defeated from your determination. Lose patience. Otherwise, how can you get? Can't get. Therefore, this is Rupa Goswami's instruction, Upadesama. Most important. One should understand. Thereby it is proved that you are not serious, you are superfluous. You are not serious, you are superfluous. How can you get Krishna? How can you approach Krishna? How can you understand Krishna? A superfluous person cannot. Shallow, he is very shallow. You are not deep. You understand? You are not serious. He is superfluous. You understand? So, this instruction is there. And this is very, very important instruction. One is intelligent, stick to this instruction, yes. Stick to this instruction, isn't it? Then he can come out successful. He'll achieve success. Well, how can I achieve success? You understand? One has no patience, he cannot achieve success. He cannot achieve success. No patience. So many failures will come. But his patience, no, again. Then the failures will be the pillars of success. That is said. Failures are the pillars of success. The patient, one who has developed patience, he'll come out success. Successful. He achieves success. Nobody can achieve success. There is patience, darja. Have patience. Be serious. Have patience. Then Krishna, in the heart, as Paramatma, understands. Oh, very serious. He is not going out, not living at all. We say, leech-like tenacity. Leech-like, leech. Not getting up, not going up. As long as I am not achieved, I won't leave. That's less like to us. You understand? Otherwise, one cannot get. No. Yes, don't go there.
So in the beginning we have enthusiasm for Krishna consciousness. We can say also because then we start following the principles. I mean, we become more purified in terms, but then spiritual life becomes more difficult. This is like Maya test and your sincerity, yeah?
In the beginning you had enthusiasm. Do you understand? It came. But you cannot keep up that enthusiasm. You lose it. Why do you lose it? What's the reason?
I think offenses. can be, but at the same time cannot be, because you become, you fall in the principles, become much sincerer than before.
Because it is ever increasing process, not decreasing. This process is such process. It's ever increasing, 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 increasing. But why are you decreasing? Because of this association with non-devotees is the only reason. You have not associated all. You don't associate with such devotee. It's such devotee or devotees through whose association you can increase it. You can develop it. That is the only reason. You understand? You associate with such persons or devotees, as you say, apparent devotees. Apparently they are devotees. Not real devotees. Apparent. You have associated with such persons, which are apparently devotees. They have lost their enthusiasm. So you lose. Do you understand me? That is very simple. It's apparent. You think, oh yes, I am associating the devotees. I am in the association of the devotees. I am in the temple. I am following the principles. But why do you lose? And why do you lose? Huh? Why do you lose enthusiasm? Why do you lose patience? Why don't you develop patience? Why do you develop enthusiasm? Why are you deviating from your determination? Why? Because your association is not correct or bona fide association. You understand? It's apparent. It's only apparent. You understand? It's apparent. You associate with such persons or devotees, those who have lost all these things. In other words, those who are offenders. Those committed offenses. And you have associated with them. Therefore you lose. That why you commit offense? That is why you lose. You understand? Yes.
Everybody said since Srila Prabhupada left the planet, enthusiasm
diminished. Yes. Yes. The sense is just diminished. Why diminished?
They haven't associated with pure sadhus.
Yes. They are superfluous. They are superfluous persons. They are not serious persons. So they cannot get. So they lose. This is the only reason. One is superfluous, one is very serious. Krishna knows, he is there in your heart. No, he is a serious person. He is always crying in his heart, how to get me? How to know me, how to approach me? He is crying, crying, crying. Krishna will help you. Krishna is always there. And the sadhus are sadhu or sadhus are also there. Also there. You understand? Also there. We cannot see sadhu. Therefore we say there is no sadhu. You understand? We cannot see him. We cannot understand him. Therefore we say there is no sadhu. It is not a fact that there is no sadhu. Sadhu is always there. As Krishna is there, sadhu is there. Definitely. But we can see. We have defective vision, so we cannot see. Do you understand? Therefore we say, that's not a fact. So they say so. Since Prabhupada left, nobody is there. So we decrease. So we say. Krishna is always there, Krishna is everywhere, lovely, Those who can give you Krishna, those dear devotees of Krishna, so sadhus are also there. Yes. Otherwise, how things are going on? How some signs, how the wind blows, how the moon shines, how all these things are going on. How Indra gives rain and like this. How it is going on? There's no Krishna and no sadhana. How things go on? How is that? You are blind, you can see. Yes, that the defect lies with you. Defect lies with you. Not with Krishna or sadhana. You lies in you. I'm blind. I cannot see. One should admit his own fault, own defect. Don't find fault with others. Admit your own fault, own defect. You understand? Yes.
You can say that the physical presence of sadhu is much stronger than his instructions.
Yes, sadhu is there, so physical presence is there. Why not? Huh?
Okay, Srila Prabhupada left, although his instructions are here. But
yeah. Prabhupada said, associate with sadhus. Then ask Prabhupada, you left. How can you associate with sadhus? Where are sadhus? Then get answer from Prabhupada. Prabhupada says, sadhus are there. Go and associate with them. Find out them.
Maybe
we
started very cheaply, thinking we're all associated with
sadhus.
Anyone that wears
tilak. Yeah, I said it's apparent. It's only apparent. It's apparent.
Very cheaply.
Very cheap. It's not so cheap. Krishna is not so cheap. The sadhu is not so cheap. You understand? One who is serious, therefore, this seriousness. My Guru Maharaj said, this is my serious student. Take it seriously.